Today we are going to see on the concept AngularJS modules. First of all, what is meant by module, what is meant by controller, and how we can make use of that particular modules, controllers in this particular video we are going to see now. Basically, you might have learned some concepts like C++, some technologies like C++, Java, this particular technologies you might have seen, where we might have seen the concepts of classes. Similarly, as we have classes in our C, C++, Java, etc. languages, here we have modules, controllers, etc. What is that module? How that module can be defined? How to make use of modules to define controllers? We are going to see now. First, module. Module is just a container similar to our class, where we can define all our controllers, we can define all our services, factories, etc. etc. In upcoming programs, you will be seeing that particular concepts. Where, for the time being, I will be showing you how to define a module, how to define a controller within the module. Where, here you can see, for creating a module, angular.module you have to use. What is the name of the module? I want to create a module with the name test module. And here, second parameter, I am not taking any parameters over here. I have kept it empty. In the sense, I am not depending on any of the extra plugins. What is that extra plugins? How to make use of extra plugins and upcoming programs you will be learning slowly. For the time being, just ignore about that particular extra plugins. Just I am defining one particular module. The name of the module is test module. What is there inside the module? Nothing. I didn't define any controller, I didn't define any services or anything. Just I have defined one module. That particular module I am using over here. Just a simple module declaration I have shown over here. Whereas this particular module will be available from this particular div until the end of the div. How many ever lines it goes till the end of that particular view, that particular module will be applicable. Next, what is controller? Basically, controller is like a function where we can implement our logic, we can initialize the variables, whatever the operations you want to perform before generating the output on the viewer, we can define, we can perform the operations by making use of controller. You can see, I have defined a module, test app, there is no plugins I am depending on. For this particular module, I have created an object, app. By making use of that app, I am defining a controller. You can see that controller over here. The name of the controller is test controller. Within this controller, if you want to perform any logics, if you want to perform any operations, you can perform the operations over here. Next, one more thing you need to observe over here. Dollar scope. Here you can see dollar scope is a parameter for your controller. What is this dollar scope? If you need to transfer the data from the, model to the viewer, whereas if you need to do any changes, you can see here by making use of scope in a field, if I did any changes, if I update any values over here in the controller, immediately that will be applicable to the model as well as viewer also. Scope is an object where we can hold the data for transferring between your model as well as controller. In between, if you need to perform any operations, if you need to validate the data, we can make use of the scope variables only. There are several types of scope variables available. How many types of scope variables are there? We will be seeing in upcoming programs. Whereas, Now, by making use of this particular NG controller and this module, my controller and module, we will be seeing an example now. Yeah, this is the example where you can see I have a module. The module name is test app, where for this particular module I have created an object test. By making use of test, I am creating a controller. The controller name is test controller. It is taking scope as a parameter. You can see $scope. So whatever I store it into $scope, that can be used here for displaying, here for binding also. Now, scope.data, I am creating an array where array is holding the values 1 to 8. Okay, from 1 we are storing 8 values. Now you can see, if I need to use this module, module name is test app. If I need to use this controller, test controller, you can see here, within the div, this test app will work. That means whatever the module I have created over here, only applicable for this div only. Next, the same way, this controller also. This controller will be applicable for this div. I have specified test controller, so it will be applicable for this particular div only. So whatever is there in this module, whatever is there in this controller, I can use it within this div. Let's say, what is there? Data array is there. That data array I am using over here, I am iterating, storing into x. That x I am printing over here. Like this, I will be iterating how many times? Totally 8 times I will be iterating, so that it will be creating unordered list items over here for generating the result on the web page. I am using expression tag ng repeat for iterating. Already we have seen that examples also, ng repeat and expression tag, in my previous video. Now I am applying the same thing, ng repeat and expression tag for this controller as well as ng app. I mean module and controller. Let me show you the result. You can see where after iteration from 1 to 8 it is displaying list items. This is the module and the controller is all about. This is a way to define the module and controller. Next, I am going to show you the second way of creating module and controller. Yes. Now we are going to see another way of defining modules and controllers. Another way is nothing but, that is not a new concept, just remove. We don't want any object. Directly you can proceed with this one. That's it. Directly angular module, continuation I am creating the controller, within that controller only I am creating an array, and I will be making use of that array over here. You can see, same output will be generated over here. This is another way of defining module and controller. Next, we will be seeing how to define the functions within the module. Yeah, this is an example for functions within the controller. You can see here I have module and I have a controller. Within that particular controller, I have declared employee number as 1, employee name as hello, and I have defined one function. The name of the function is myDetails. Even that particular employee number is underscore, employee name is also underscore, this function is also available under the scope. What this function is doing, whenever if anybody calls myDetails, this will be concatenating employee number, employee name as single string, and it will be returning to that particular invoker. You can see Here, by making use of expression tag, I am calling that particular function. Where here that module is also applicable, controller is also applicable. I am calling that particular function. This function will concatenate both employee number, employee name, returns to this. Here it will print 1 and hello. Let me show you the result. You can see 1 and hello has been displayed over here. That's all about modules, controllers over here. Thank you.